So I'm Jelena Erceg. I'm a postdoctoral researcher in a group of Ting Wu and at Harvard Medical School. So we are in Boston, Massachusetts. This is a lab of Ting Wu. So here where the people sit. Currently they are not there. We also have a little break room where we take our lunches, and now it's about lunchtime, so people are eating. And here is where I sit. So currently I'm working on trying to understand the regulation of genes in three dimensions. For many years we were thinking of regulation in two dimensions, and now we realized and have techniques and approaches to look at it in a better way, how it all folds and looks in 3D. So I'm originally from Croatia. It's a small but beautiful country in the southern part of Europe. In high school, I decided I'm very much interested in nature around me, and there were so many questions popping up, mixed also with philosophical questions. I wanted something which could give me answers to all these questions that started going around in my head. And then through all the classes we had in high school, I kind of decided maybe molecular biology, genetics could be a way to approach these questions, because it seemed like a sound scientific method which gives you some kind of hypothesis, and then you do some testings so you can more firmly answer your ideas that you might have. Because we can think of research, for example, in two layers: as the basic one, which gets you answers to some fundamental questions, and also as the one which we can apply that knowledge to help humanity, if you want. They are kind of interconnected with each other. To have the applied research, you also need a lot of knowledge which comes from the fundamental basic research, and that's what I'm more interested in. I think many scientists are very curious and also creative, inventive. And science is a very broad term in itself. So you can be a biologist, a chemist, a bioinformatician, or a linguist, which I was thinking. So they all use a similar method of thinking about rationally how to design experiments, setting up hypotheses, answering this, and very critically evaluating your results. But in science, you never know what's going to happen, because the career of being a scientist, there is no one wrote a little protocol for you saying to you, now you go from A to B, from B to C. Things are kind of open, so you see where things lead you. Because you might, research is like you are doing most of the time, maybe 80-90% of the time, you're doing things and these things just fail. And then maybe 15 or 10 or even less percent of the time, something happens. It's this like Eureka feeling, oh, I discovered something, and that something is amazing, which makes up for all the time when things were not working. So you have to see where things will take you. Maybe just around the corner is the big discovery waiting for you.